the saline irrigation. So I just make a deeper cut at the level of the apex, close to apex, smoothen this area, and I know now the depth of the. Okay, cut this one. As I mentioned to you, this is not a big gland, but again the patient is having obstruction because of the peculiar anatomy of the gland, I guess. Now we are making finished touches on the right lobe, and I told you I like to do finished touches later on, not in the beginning. Because in the beginning if you open a sinus and start bleeding, it hampers your vision. The coagulation in bipolar is white, it does not charge the prostatic fossa. It does not charge the prostatic fossa. As I said, this is a small gland, so I am not intending to resect it anteriorly completely. See, I have left a strip of mucosa anteriorly here, half a centimeter strip I have left anteriorly. This is not adenomatous strip, it is just the mucosal strip. And the reason I leave it is that it prevents the bladder neck contracture to my mind. The anterior part of fossa is not raw. See, it's a mucosa only. It is not dead. It is not sort of a raw. So probably it will reduce the incidence of contracture. Okay. You can come back. Come back, and this is the level of the resection. And you can clean a little bit more on the right side. Some tissue. You have to actually cut in a manner that you create a fossa effect. See, this is the capsule again, which I opened, right? It's a little deep cut. But again, it is not absorbing, so not bleeding, so not the problem at all. I am fortunate that way, and I cut a little bit here. You have to cut to the capsule. You will appreciate that I am taking thin chips. This black bag tissue that is coming is a corpora malacea. This, if this is a kind of a thing, you can also make a retrograde cut. When we retrograde cut, they get interrupted. While you are resecting, in between you should go in the bladder lumen. Come back in the fossa and go in the bladder lumen in between to drain the bladder a little bit. Otherwise bladder may become overfull and you will never know about it. The chips are pushed back into bladder lumen. We later on retrieve the chips. I'll show you the way to retrieve the chips. A small tissue here, you may not do anything about it because there is sinus here. You may not do anything about it. Okay. The small vesicles there, let's coagulate them. Turn left. Turn. It needs some bit of hollowing here. Now working on the left lobe. Finish touches on the left lobe. Appreciate the lower limit of the resection just by the head of the varomontanum, because varo is here small. This is anterolateral up to the level of the apex. Don't deepen it here. If you deepen it here, it will end up in a big sinus here. And usually the sinus at this location bleed. Again, I'm shaving a little bit. Adenoma anterolaterally. I don't expect much tissue here also again. This is now close to the capsule. Close to the capsule. Thank you. anterolaterally, the left side. This area also close to capsule. You can appreciate I'm cutting very small chips. The reason it is a small gland, I can't help it. Large glands need large chips, small gland need small chips. Again, this is getting deep here. So I think we are close to completion of the resection in this patient, and we'll have a look at